I'm going to violate what I just said, and I'm going to quote one critic of Islam, and he'll probably quote plenty of critics of Christianity. Ali Dashti, and I'm sure Shabir knows who he is. He explains that one of Muhammad's followers, Abdullah Sarh, made many suggestions to the Prophet about improving the Quran by rephrasing it, adding to it or deleting from it, suggestions which Muhammad, he said, followed. Eventually, however, Sarh defected from Islam, having at last faced the obvious fact that if the Quran were truly from God, it wouldn't need to be improved in wording and concepts and could not be changed. When Mecca was conquered, Abdullah Sarh was one of the first put to death by Muhammad. That's the way they enforce truth in Islam. I don't want to insult anybody out there, but let me just put it in my terms. Islam is a peaceful religion. And if you don't believe it, we'll kill you to prove it. That's sort of what goes on. And they killed him, did away with him as a critic. Now, I have some problems with that way of enforcing truth.
You notice that he quoted Ali Dashti about a certain scribe who said that he was changing things to suit himself in the Quran, and that Muhammad killed that scribe. But the best information we have about that scribe is that, in fact, he, after reneging from Islam, came back into the Muslim faith, and he survived the Prophet Muhammad. So to say that the Prophet Muhammad killed him, that's incorrect. And to cite Ali Dashti about this is to cite a non-scholar, as far as I'm concerned. I have no reason for believing that Ali Dashti has expertise in these matters, especially since we have historical information about this particular scribe.
Did this man who, he says, that's not the story I got, who repented and went back to Islam? I don't think so. That's not what I get from history.